Welcome back to another video. Now, in this current video, we are going to be addressing the Emsat Physics and Emsat Mathematics examination, in which we are going to be selecting every single video as part of a series of videos, a question straight from the Emsat Math and Emsat Physics examination. This will help you as part of your Emsat practice, revision, preparation for your Emsat examination, whether physics or mathematics. In addition, take a look at the video description where we have very important and useful links for videos which are for our members of the channel, in addition to links to courses and workshops straight on our academy, which have been highly reviewed. Students are enrolling in the courses and they are seeing results. Now, without further ado, make sure that you subscribe and click the notification bell in order to stay tuned with all of these releases for every single upcoming question. Now, let's get right to the problem. So we do have a question straight from the physics examination. Let's go through the question. We have a car which is moving away from a motion detector with a constant speed. Which graph best represents the motion of the car? So let's go about this problem. If I would like to sketch the motion, let's say I have a detector over here, and the car starts from this current position the same way as the detector, and it moves away from the detector with a constant speed. Now, if you take a look at the options that you have, all of these options are represented by a distance time graph. So we got a distance time graph over here, and a distance time graph over here, and a distance time graph over here as well. So we are dealing with a distance time graph to represent our motion. So if I would like to sketch a distance time graph in order to understand the motion, even though this is quite a simple problem, the distance time graph represents the movement with a constant speed in the form of a straight line. Since we are moving from the starting point over here, which is the origin or the detector, we are going to start from the zero point, and then we are going to move with a constant speed. Since the slope of this line is considered to be the speed, so if I want to represent the slope, this is the run, this is the rise, the slope equals to the speed. So if we have a constant speed, it means the slope should be in the form of a straight line like this. So the distance time graph should have a straight line in order to provide or represent the speed, which is the constant speed. Now let's evaluate the options that we have. Now, option number A, or letter A, is not going to be the correct answer because we are not starting from the origin. We are starting from somewhere above the origin, which is not the case. If I take a look at option C, for example, now the line or the graph that we have, it's a curved line. It's bending upwards, which is not the case that we're dealing with, because it shows that at every moment in time, if I would like to take the slope for these points, we're not going to have a constant speed. We are going to have a different kind of speed at every single point because this is a quadratic curve. It's bending upwards. So this one does not work as well. How about C? If you take a look at C, as time passes by, the distance is the same. Now, if we have the same distance, it means we are still at the origin. We did not move at all. Since the slope of a horizontal line is zero, it means the speed is zero in this current graph as well. So this current curve does not work either. We end up with B. B is the correct answer, because if you take a look at the graph, we are starting from the origin and we are moving in a straight line as time passes by. the more time elapses, the same incremental distance. Hence, we do have a constant speed and we do have a constant value for the slope. So we conclude from this current question that the answer is going to be B. So this is one of the methods that you can use in order to solve problems during your MSAT examination. You can either directly find the correct answer. If you are confused, start by eliminating the answers which do not work and then find the leftover answer and confirm that this is the right answer. Now, I truly hope that you found this current question helpful and beneficial. Now, stay tuned for the upcoming releases in which we are going to have a series, numerous questions that are surely going to support you in terms of the preparation for the MSAT Physics and Mathematics. Don't forget to take a look at the video description for all of these links related to important courses, workshops, tools, membership videos. Some videos we are going to be releasing addressing key important questions from the MSAT examination are going to be dedicated for the channel members. So if you're interested in that as well, take a look at the video description for all of these details. In the meanwhile, don't forget to subscribe, click and smash that like button, and I'll see you in the upcoming video.